Starting with the name of Allah Almighty, who is the most beneficent and the most merciful. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Radiant Secondary School. I hope all of you will be fine and doing great. As we know that due to the prevailing situation of COVID-19, we have started our new academic session online. So before going to take a start, I would like to give you the heartiest congratulations on promoting to grade 8. So today, we are going to take a start of 8th biology. Today, we are going to discuss about the chapter number 1, that is about the introduction to biology. The few major topics that today we are going to discuss is biology and its branches. So now come towards the very first term, that is the biology. Biology is basically derived from the two Greek words. The first word is bio, meaning life, and the second word is logos, meaning thought and reasoning. So we can define biology as the scientific study of life. When you are going to study about the life, it will be included in biology. When you are going to study about the different life processes that are occurring inside the living organism, for example, photosynthesis, respiration, excretion, movement, etc., it will be included in biology. Anything related to the life, when you are going to study about them, it will be included in biology. So now come towards the division of biology. As we know that the life will be existed in different forms on the earth. For example, life may be existed in the form of animals, in the form of plants, or in the form of microorganisms. That's why we have divided biology into the three major divisions. The first division of biology is botany. We can define botany as the study of plants. When you are going to study about the plants, about the life processes that is occurring in the plants, for example, photosynthesis, it will be included in the term botany. Now, the next division of biology is zoology. So, zoo means animals and logy means study. So, the study of animals is basically known as zoology. When you are going to study about the different animals, for example, cats, dogs, zebras, it will be included in zoology. Now, come towards the third division of biology, that is microbiology. We know that the word micro means small. And so we can say that microbiology is basically the study of microorganisms. And we are very familiar with the term microorganism as those organisms that cannot be seen by the naked eye. For example, the study of viruses, bacteria, and fungi. When we are going to study about these microorganisms, it will be included in microbiology. Now, we are going to discuss about the few branches of biology. The first one is morphology. Second one is anatomy, third one is histology, and the fourth one is cell biology. Now let's come towards the first branch of biology, that is morphology. We can define morphology as the study of form and structure of living organisms. When we are just going to study about the form and structure of living organisms, it will be included in morphology. For example, the study of form and structure of eyes, ear, and brain. And when you are going to study about the form and structure of any organ, it will be included in morphology. Now come towards the next branch of biology, that is anatomy. We can define anatomy as the study of internal structure. We can define anatomy as the study of internal structures of living organisms. For example, the study of internal structure of digestive system, the study of internal structure of eye, the study of internal structure of ear. It will be included in anatomy. Now come towards another branch of biology, that is histology. We can define histology as the microscopic study of tissues. When we are going to study about the tissues in detail, it will be included in histology. And we are very familiar with the term tissues as the group of the similar cells that are specialized for the performance of a common function. These are basically known as tissues. And when you are going to study about the tissues in detail with the help of microscope, it will be included in histology. For example, the animals' bodies, they are also composed of the wide variety of tissues, just like the epithelial tissue, as you can see here in this diagram. And some epithelial tissues is present on the epidermal layer of your skin. Just like the animal body, the plant body is also composed of the various types of tissues. For example, xylem tissue and the phloem tissue. Xylem tissue is basically responsible for the transport of water, while the phloem tissue is responsible for the transport of food. Now come towards the last branch of biology that today we are going to discuss about is cell biology. So as the term indicates that in this branch we are going to study about the cell. We can define cell biology as the study of structure and function of cell and cell organelles. When you are going to study about the structure and functions of cells and cell organelles, it will be included in cell biology. For example, cell organelles, we are very familiar with the term organelles. We know that the cell is composed of the different types of organelles like lysosomes, mitochondria, Golgi apparatus. When you are going to study about the plant cell and animal cell, it will be included in cell biology. And cell biology, it also deals with the cell division. Cell division means that how the new cells, they are going to be formed. How new cells, they arise from the previously existing cell, from the pre-existing cell. All these things that are related to the cell will be studied in the cell biology.